Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the Victoria Memorial Hall. Namaskar shobaike. Apnara shokali jemon janen, and I think I will use a kind of mixed language because there are people here who understand Bengali. There are people here like Malcolm who would prefer to listen to English.
Yeah?
Of course, you do. I know that you understand Bengali. Right. So, this week happens to be World Heritage Week, and every year it is World Heritage Week from the 19th to the 25th of November. And during this week, we try in our own way to kind of promote things which need to be promoted as part of the Heritage Week, though the week is possibly designated such so that you can have a kind of focused attention towards certain tangible and intangible heritage things which are either going extinct or need to be preserved and conserved in some manner. But it is an exercise that has to go on throughout the year, because otherwise it doesn't make sense. So with that in mind, and this being the centenary year of Victoria Memorial Hall, which was thrown open to the public on the 28th of December 1921, so 28th of December this year, it's going to be 100 years. So we thought that we would use this opportunity to maybe look back a little bit at heritage and also look forward a little bit as to how to take this whole concept of heritage forward. Before saying anything further, I would also like to apologize on behalf of our secretary and curator, Dr. Jayendra Sengupta, who couldn't be here in person today because he has another meeting to attend. So what we thought was, a few months ago, we said a lot has been done around the museum, inside the museum, and so on and so forth. But what about this huge 58-acre campus, which such a diversity, such a biodiversity, so to speak, which the common people perhaps do not realize. And that is when we decided to get Madam Susmita Basu to the picture, because she on her own, as part of several nature organizations, had been doing a lot of study within the campus of the Victoria Memorial Hall, not on behalf of the Victoria Memorial Hall, but more out of her own interest and their organization's interest. Like, we got to know about her when Prakriti Shanshat did an event over here in this particular conference hall. And that's the time we said, wow, she knows this place inside out. So we thought, let us request her to, in a very concerted manner, in a very systematic manner, do an audit of the biodiversity, particularly the trees and so on here, in the campus of the Victoria Memorial Hall. And she very gladly took up this assignment because that was something actually very close to her heart. And she put a small team together of experts and research scholars who worked over a period of a few months. And now we have a lot of data about what there is in the Victoria Memorial Hall campus. And this we would like to share with the people also. So the idea is that today is like a kind of trailer for what is in store here. And Susmita Basu Madam will take us around. Before that, she will give us a little presentation over here. And the intention is that from January 2022, we would make this a regular affair even for visitors. Just as there are guided tours within the museum now, on Mondays the museum is closed. So on those days, we will probably utilize to offer to visitors a guided tour through the gardens of the Victoria Memorial Hall, which could again be divided into specialized subjects. One day could be trees, another day could be flowers, another day could be butterflies or whatever. So let me also in this context mention that another initiative we have already undertaken and which is underway is that we are setting up a butterfly garden within this campus and an aroma garden, the seeds for which have been already sown. So the results will probably show up in early spring next year. So we at least hope so. So all these initiatives are on the anvil. Part of them are already underway. So it is in this context that we have assembled here together, so that you as multiplicators can have a look at the kind of diversity that is here and tell other people about it. So once it is functional and we are able to do it on Mondays from January, then we may even invite, by which time we hope that it will be more liberal and open for school children as well, that we get blocks of school children also as a part of a study for their nature project, that part of the project they do in school and part of it they do here as a practical lesson. So which would then be a kind of meaningful outreach program, not only for the Victoria Memorial, but also for the schools concerned. So that is the idea. So with these few words, may I invite Susmita Basu Madam to kindly take the microphone, take us through the small presentation, and take us through the guided tour on the lawns of the Victoria Memorial.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rahul. Raman said a number of kind words. I am not very sure whether I am equal to it, but well, let's start. There are trees collected from different continents in the garden of Victoria Memorial. I have more or less focused on those which are quite old. Some of them predate Victoria Memorial. We are not very sure, as there is no conclusive proof of age determination done meanwhile. So what we will do is, we will just focus on a few trees, and after that we will go out in the garden and look at the trees concerned. This tree, many of us are aware of it. It is often used as an avenue tree. It's the Indian almond or wild almond. Nothing with the taste of almond, but not very bad either, if properly prepared, I think. It has a lot of flowers around March, April, and after that fruits. They turn red. There are black seeds inside. There is a close-up of flowers. This particular tree is very near the East Gate. I am not sure whether it predates the memorial, but it's quite old. It's very tall. This is the tallest one here. It is the back mangrove species. That is, it is found in areas where the highest tides reach, particularly in Sundarban Biosphere Reserve. As it grows on swampy soil, the trunk is fluted, as you may see. It is also quite common in Southeast Asia, and the flowers are usually edible and used as food, particularly in Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, and so on. This one, Horitoki, planted by somebody from memorial itself. Huge tree and has a number of fruits right now. And here's a very large Arjuna tree, Carmelia Arjuna. All these trees till now are, which I have shown, are in the plot adjacent to the East Gate, just the north of East Gate. Also shown now, but in many areas of the city, the flowers are sprouted and grown. This tree probably predates Victoria Memorial. has got a huge pedicle around, as far as I remember, something like 459 inches. The number of buckets the tree was broken in some storm, probably at the beginning of the last century, or maybe even before that, because all the persons I asked, even the oldest person that could remember, who could remember this particular tree, saw it as it is broken, but it's quite high. The leaves are like this. And this is the pod. It's a winged seed. In fact, that's how the name Taro Karpos came in. Taro, winged, and Karpos is fruit. The light green part, outer part, that's the wing, and it helps float down this seed to float down to the ground. The tree is just in the middle. On the right, that's the young tree. It's a Uddhanarike or Tilikota Anata. The one in the middle, that is quite old. It may also predate the memorial. It is Puttanjiva Roxburghi, or as it is called now, Victis Roxburghi. The fruits are usually used in villages as a garland to put in the around the necks of children to ensure a long life. That's how the name Puttanjiva came into being. This one is also a tree which probably predates the memorial. It's a very slow growth. This tree has got a very slow growth and the bark is quite interesting. Actually, there are three branches. Very near the ground, the third branch goes over the mango cones, so it isn't seen well from this angle. It flowers around June, July. Very nice fragrant flowers. It is very common in South India, Ceylon, and in general Southeast Asia, the equatorial part. The oil derived from the seeds are used in cosmetics. The tree in the middle, it does not look like mast tree of Devdaru, but it is one. It has got very small narrow leaves, not as large as the Devdaru proper, but it has got narrow leaves, and it's a variety of Devdaru, that is mast tree, a variety angustifolia, that is angustifolia means narrow leaves. The flowers are very much similar. This one is in the northeast corner of the garden, another huge tree, and it is also a scape tree. Devil's tree or Alstonia scholaris. Devil's tree because earlier people used to think that if you fall asleep under the tree, it would bad luck would befall the person. But the wood of the tree was once used to make slates, and that's where the scholarly term comes from. This one is a tree with the single largest girth in whole of Victoria Memorial Garden. This is not a tree of Asia. This is a Central American tree. In fact, this is a national tree of Costa Rica. It is elephant earpod or earpod tree. And you can, if you see the satellite map of Victoria Memorial, this tree is very much visible as a round umbrella-like canopy. In the northwestern side, water body. It has got white flowers. It doesn't flower each year. This year it haven't flowered. So there are no pods available right now. This one is an African tree. The pods are used as vegetables. It has got a lot of protein in it. But this particular tree, because I have never seen fruits in it. Flowers, a lot of time, fruits never till date. Not sure whether anybody had the flowers look like this. Hence the other name, badminton ball tree. This one is an Indian tree, or rather I would say a tree from northeastern part of India. It is very common in Myanmar, Burma that is. It has got the flowers, I think they are strewn in the ground right now. Long white tube like corolla, small white petals and very, very fragrant. What the flowers look like. This one is another tree of Equatorial Asia. It is also found in Andaman Nicobar in India. It is Dipterocarpus alata. Two winged. The first part and even the second part also means wing. The reason for this is it flowers around April. In February, and by the time of April, winged pods form in the tree. The wings turn bright red, and after that fall down and give rise to new seedlings. Hopefully, this is another tree which is from outside India. It's very small pink flowers. These flowers can also be seen right now. At least a few flowers are still visible as far as I could see. The trunk looks like this. The epithet hospital refers to its hospitality to various insects which stay in the tree. This is a Buddha Narikel on Terracotta Alata. This flowers in early March. Gives rise to fruits, very common. Sometimes these are collected for decorative purposes. And winged seeds. Koronjo or Pongamia Kinata. Which is very useful, particularly to the remote villagers. The oil is extracted and used by villagers for cosmetic purposes. This is another quite rare tree. This is also an indigenous tree, but this is something which is rarely seen in avenues, in the tree of Western Ghats. Very beautiful orange color, small tube like flowers, and the trunk is very distinct. It looks like this. The interesting thing is this particular tree, although it's quite huge, this can be tended in a small pot as well. Forms a cortex and gives rise to leaves. This is also an African tree, the sausage tree, named after the fruit, the shape of the fruit, not the taste. It has got large red flowers, which hang down, and large sausage-shaped fruits. These are not edible, at least for human edibility, it's not edible. Quite huge. If one drops on somebody, he or she would be quite hard. The South American tree, very small tree, this is also near East Bay. Presentia pujete. It shows coniferae, that is the flowers form directly on the trunk or branches. And the flowers are very favorite with the squirrels in the garden. And huge fruits. Fruits are not edible for human beings or to any animals here. In South America, it is tapirs are fond of it. That's all. Thank you very much. And now we are going to stroll in the garden a bit and look at the trees there.
Approximately how long?
1 hour.
45 minutes to 1 hour. Yeah? So that is fine. And we will give you all a bottle of water so that you can carry it around. Because if, while you are strolling around, you might. So please grab a bottle of water before you go out. And our caretaker, Mr. Deepak Rai, also tells us that while you are going around, the orutoki, which he pointed out on one of the slides, is something you can pick up if you want to, and the security will not stop you from taking them away. The mosquito is a very important.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Did you hear that there is some enemy talk?
Now at present, things are just on
বসিরহাটে আমি নামটা শুনেছি। ইনফ্যাক্ট বসিরহাটে ব্রিজে ওঠার আগে মানে ব্রিজের ঠিক পাশে বাঁদিকে একটা খুব বড় এরকম গাছ আছে।
আচ্ছা, এই গাছগুলো শুধু গাছই মানে এর থেকে ফ্রুট বা কোনো কিছু
ফ্লাওয়ারটা এটি
শুধু
মানে অনেক জায়গাতে সাউথ ইস্ট এশিয়া অনেক জায়গায় খাওয়া হয়, আমরা খাই না, আমাদের এখানে চলনি। কিন্তু সে ফর এক্সাম্পল আমরা কারি পাতা তরাই বেল্টে বিশেষ খাওয়া হয় না, সাউথ ইন্ডিয়ায় খুবই খাওয়া হয়, অথচ পুরো তরাই বেল্টে কারি পাতা পাওয়া যায় জঙ্গলে।
আমরা বকফুলটাও তো আমরা ভেজে খাই,
scientific name te bolo
শিমুল এখানে দেখি আমরা কলকাতায় দেখি শিমুল সোজা লম্বা উঠে যাচ্ছে আপনারা যদি নর্থ বেঙ্গলে যান গিয়ে কিন্তু দেখুন অনেক উঁচুতে উঠে গেছে এর ফুলটা কারোরই প্রায় চোখে পড়ে না খুব ছোট ফুল হয় হলুদ রঙের ভেরি স্মল ইয়েলো ফ্লাওয়ার আর ফর এ ভেরি স্মল পিরিয়ড ফর অনলি অ্যাবাউট এ ফোর্টনাইট অফ
হ্যাঁ এটা কি
ছাতি ফর অ্যাস্ট্রোনিয়াস স্কলারিস দিস ইজ অর ডিফেন্স ট্রি দিস ইজ অলসো দ্য স্টেট ট্রি অফ ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল
ফর
সপ্তপর্ণী
হাউ ওল্ড ইজ দিস ট্রি হাউ ওল্ড ইজ দিস ট্রি ম্যাম How old would be this tree? How old is this? Because the ones that you see here are quite young. We all have fallen.
শীতকালে এখানে পাতা ঝরে না
ওইটাতে ওইটা আছে আছে ওখানে ওই ওখানে আছে হ্যাঁ গোল গোল এত বড় হ্যাঁ রুদ্রাক্ষ যেটা মারা হয়
রুদ্রাক্ষ
ওটা আপনি দেখলেন ওই তো পরে দুটো আছে একটা বড় একটা ছোট দুটো আছে
বুঝতে তো হচ্ছে
রাজু
ড্রাই করে তারপরে আপনার রুদ্রাক্ষটা গেরে দেবেন
ছাড়া This is hartaki, yeah. This is lovely. Can we just pick up some hartaki from here? Can we just take some?
Yeah, it's first.
This is excellent, excellent for digestion. Superb for digestion.
Hartaki.
You have to dry it till it's absolutely dry.
And then
anti-constipation. You simply grind it in ghee. Grind roasted in ghee.
And then have it like that.
Yeah, you paco it like a churan.
Or you can go to Sri Ayurveda and just buy the bonfire.
अजून चार दिवस देखेशी
What is this called?
Hortuki.
Oh, that is not edible. Oh, it's South America.
Essentia pugete. Leaves are somewhat spoon shaped. And flowers come out directly from the branch.
আমি আসছি আমার আমার গাছ তো দেখিনি কত কত দেখা আছে কিন্তু সেরকম প্রবলেম নেই
Walks on it.
That's the thing.
মানে বিভিন্ন কোথায় কি গাছ আছে ওই নিয়ে কত বছর পুরনো গাছ গাছের নাম কি তো দূরে যাবো গাছটা তো পুরো কভারেই আসছে না
যে কোনো সময় একই রকম ভাবে picks them up and takes them home, and they will be very pleasant to work the whole night.
Mitintunia hortensis, originally from Myanmar. A very large tree, but the one thing is it topples very easily in a storm. So it shouldn't be planted as an avenue tree, or it shouldn't be planted in an area where the winds will get at it at the first attempt.
We had one in our garden, it toppled. We raised the whole trunk up.
There used to be tree in other than bark. At this point, I was in your life, but now there's only one left. Because of the fragrance, it is called Neem Chameli in Hindi. Akash Neem and Himjhuri. Himjhuri is, yes, Rabindranath is the name given by Rabindranath. Very fragrant flowers in the winter seasons, at the beginning of the winter. And there is one large Aurobindo Bhavan as well, as far as I remember.
Tolishlabe
onek gulo ache, root sakar theke bhorti hoye ache, apni southern dike gele bhorti hoye ache. Ami shesh jokhon geslam odike ekbar, tokhon mone ache ja. And it suffers very well from the root, so the plants will spring up everywhere around it.
Telling her to take a
shower. I'm not coming to take a shower.
Which is used to garnish items. What do you think?
That's a very big sausage.
May I request all of you, on behalf of all of us, to give Susmita ma'am a big hand.
Thank you, thank you.
I thank the Victoria Memorial Authorities for arranging this.
Oh.
Another clap for them.
Yes, yes.
And no tour is complete without some tea, so please have some tea. And the famous Victoria Singhadas. We thank you very much for being part of this, and we will take this forward.
Excellent program.
Excellent.